Beethoven, and it's great. And I think you're doing a much better job of showing them what you want in time, you know, or ahead of time. That's great. Comments, players?
I like how relaxed he is.
Yeah,
yeah, just relaxed and giving us your real deal. I like it. It's good. There's something about being genuine that's really, I mean, we can tell that. We can read that right away. There's no pretense here, right? Is that it? All right, let's go back and just kind of fine-tune a few things.
Okay, just start of the excerpt.
Part of my thing is you're very active. Your head is very active, and I think it's almost ADD. You know, it's like you move around almost too much. I'd like you to anchor on things a little bit longer and try not to be everything to everybody, because it just seems a little schizophrenic that way.
Okay.
Just a little bit. Okay?
And the funny thing is, I didn't have any coffee. Okay.
This. Okay, where are you getting your information? Is it coming over here? Are you looking here? Where are you looking? Probably here somewhere.
Yeah.
Right? Okay, so you're giving us two moving targets here.
It's a habit I have to break.
Yes, you do. Because I talked the other day about the crink in the hose. This is a pretty big crink here. Mm-hmm. You've got to somehow, and it comes from the way you're holding the stick, whatever that is. If you'll get that stick back next to this knuckle and between that thumb, you won't be able to do that anymore.
Yeah.
Okay, it'll automatically go where it's supposed to go. So there's something about the way you're gripping the stick, and then you start compensating, and then we get all these extra cranks.
Yeah, I've been fighting that for a little while. So I'm trying to break that habit.
If you can get this here, and just stay there, that's the textbook place, and there's a reason it's the textbook place. It works. Okay, what you've done somehow is got the tip of your finger on that stick.
Yeah.
And then you got trouble.
Yeah.
Right. And then we got this going, parallel motion.
Okay.
Okay. So did I mention this to you today? You
yes,
have a habit of looking over your
glasses.
And
I know why I do it. It's because it's a can I see you thing.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
You know, because right here it's kind of like sort of fuzzy and sort of not, and this is clear. So,
but if you take those off, you can't see the music.
Yes,
you got a problem. I have multifocals for that very reason. I don't know if you do or not, but you know, it allows me to do that. But this is just a weaker position. It's kind of a school marmy thing too. You know, you don't want that. Okay.
Okay. I'm gonna try this. See if that helps.
See if you can make bigger differences when we get to some of this subtle stuff here, when we have the subito changes of dynamics and that kind of thing. So they're all a little bit big, and you're still a little bit wide. It's better than it was the other day, but you tend to live out here.
Mm.
Okay. Eyes are a little bit better. Watch the tip. Watch the grip. Let's start at the Fermata, everybody. Okay.
Okay. Fermata in 88. nice. Here's the Fermata.
So, give us bigger differences when you get, especially the soft stuff.
It's interesting because I feel like you're still reacting a little bit late to some of the things that are happening. Oh yeah. So make sure you're there ahead of time. None of these phrases are even phrases here. It's all tricky stuff, and you just have to really know. I think the first half, like it looks, you look like a different conductor. Here, it's like you're playing catch up just a little bit. So be careful about that. So three things: try not to stay wide. Look through your glasses instead of over them, and watch this grip. Okay, but keep having a good time like you are. It's good. I would like to play for you because I think you're enjoying yourself, and I like to play for people who enjoy themselves. It's good. Good work. Okay.